Hey everybody, I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and what you're about to watch is a time-lapse video of me painting the new skull design for my business logo. It's set to music, there's no instruction within the video, and as it turns out, it falls on Halloween. How cool is that? We get to paint a skull on Halloween. Although it's a time-lapse, there's still a few things I wanted to point out. If you've watched the previous two videos on my channel, you got a little bit of a glimpse at the design process. I wasn't very happy with the first version. I went through some revisions and I'm pretty happy with the way the second one turned out. In the last video, I also showed you how you can transfer your artwork using transfer paper, which in essence gives you a mask to work with during the painting process. That's an unconventional method for painting for me personally. Not that there's anything wrong with masking techniques. They're great techniques to have in your toolbox. But if you've watched some of my other videos, you're probably aware that I really prefer to airbrush freehand the majority of the time. I had already gone through the process of transferring the image in the last video, so there was really no reason to take that off and start all over from scratch. So in this video, you also get to see a little bit of how I work with the mask. For the most part, the background is masked off during the entire painting process. I also talked about how it's a very good idea to retain any portions of the mask that you cut out for painting purposes in the event that you want to protect those areas later after you've already rendered out an area. There was no reason for me to really do that in this video. I went ahead and did it anyway just so that you guys would have a visual of what I was talking about. Pretty much all I cut out were the eye sockets and the nose sockets, which are just blacked out completely. There's really no reason, again, to cover those back up, but I did it anyway, and I did it also so that you could see that those don't always line up real well when you put them back in place. I didn't spend a lot of time trying to put them back in place, but you'll see later in the video when I actually remove them again, there are some slivers of white, the background showing through. Very easy to touch up in this case because, again, it's just blacked out. But in most cases, it's relatively easy to touch up those areas as well. So I hope you guys get something out of this. If you do, remember to like, subscribe, and share. Happy Halloween, and I will see you guys next time.